Hi, welcome to another practice skill. This one is called gluttons. Now, if you don't know what a glutton is, that is someone who typically is talking about food. They just eat way too much. They might eat all day long, and when they sit down to a meal, they just eat and eat and eat until they're way too full all the time. Okay, what does that have to do with practicing? All right, sometimes a glutton in practicing takes on way too much to practice at one time. There's three different ways to do this. First of all, you're trying to practice too many assignments at one time. You've got your theory assignment, you've got a lesson book assignment, you've got a technique assignment, you've got to memorize something, you've got all these things, and you're trying to cram it all in to one practice time. So you end up rushing through everything and nothing gets done very well. Okay, the second thing you do is if you do have like a brand new piece in your lesson book, you try to do the whole thing or too much of the thing, a whole page. You're trying to learn an entire page, and by the time you get to the end of it, you really didn't fix anything. And if you practice this way, if you start at the beginning of your song and play all the way through to the end, I hope you love practicing because this takes the longest. It's the hardest and the longest way to practice. So you'll be practicing that piece a long time. You probably don't want to do that. All right, but the third way that we do that is, let's say that we chunk it down and we take just a little section of our piece. Instead of the whole page, we're just going to do two measures, that much. But what do you try to do? You try to learn too many things at once. Like, you're going to get the notes perfect. You're going to get the dynamics perfect. You're going to get the fingering perfect. You're going to get all the articulation perfect. And you're thinking about all these things at the same time. See, there's three different ways to be a glutton in your practicing. All right, here's some ideas. First of all, I want to teach you a number. I'm going to teach you a number that has 20 digits. Okay. I'm going to say it, and let's see if you can say it back to me. Don't stop the video. Just listen to it and then stop the video and try to say it back. Here it is. 1-8-5-7-4-0-3-9-0-2-2-8-7-1-9-9-7-4-8-2. Can you do it? No. You probably can't do it because I said 20 numbers and I said it really fast. I didn't chunk it down into small, easy numbers. Now I'm going to say it kind of like a phone number. And let's see if you get, well, yeah, I'll say it like a phone number. Are you ready? 1-8-5-7-4-0-3. You might be able to remember that. But let's take just that number, or just those seven digits, like a phone number. And if you repeat it back to me, 1-8-5-7-4-0-3. Now, how about if you write it down? How about if you write it 10 times? How about if you write it, then say it, then write it, then say it? Maybe you try to write it backwards. Maybe you sing it. 1-8-5-7-4-0-3. Make up your own song. You sing it. Then write it again. Then say it really fast. Then say it really slow. Set a timer for 30 seconds and see how many times you can say it in 30 seconds. Now try to whisper it really quietly and then yell it really loud. All those different ways of practicing it, now you'd have it so good. And the beautiful thing is, you have it. You're not going to have to sit down tomorrow and relearn that part. Now you can go on to the next seven digits in that number. And within 2 or 3 days, you've got the whole number perfect. But if you just sat down and went 1-8-5-7-4-0-3-9-0-2-2-8-7-1-9-9-7-4-8-2, it will take you forever to learn it. It's too much information at once. Okay, here's one thing you can do. You have to do this with a copy. Don't, because you're going to be cutting. Don't cut up your piano book, But if you can make a copy of the song you're working on, now just take two measures and cut out those two measures. And then the next two measures, cut those out. So you just have little pieces of music. Put that up on your piano and practice just that little piece of paper. Then maybe you can put them back together like a puzzle. Once you get it learned, it goes back where it belongs in the song. You can even tape it onto another sheet of paper. Then you get those little measures, and if you do it all different ways, you'll have your whole song done much easier than trying to do the whole thing at once. So try some of those suggestions and let me know how it goes. I want you to practice that way all week on all your assignments. Talk to you later.